I've got it. I've solved it. Of course it makes so much sense. I gotta tell the police about this. They gotta know who's killing these people.
The name is Roger Corin, and I'm a professional snoop. I work these city streets day and night whenever they need me. On my days off, I like to hang out at a clip joint with a couple buddies of mine. One fits in a holster, the other fits in a glass. I'm not picky when it comes to cases. For $15 a day plus expensive, I'll believe any damn thing you want. So when the dame walked into my office claiming she needed me to solve the murder of her cousin, I didn't tell her to get lost immediately. If there's any way I could describe her, I'd say she looked like hell in high heels.
I have a case for you to solve.
Of course, you wouldn't be here otherwise.
It's about my cousin. He was found dead in his office this morning.
Really? Does your cousin have a name?
Louis Mullaney.
Louis Mullaney, the detective, he's dead?
Yes, it was in the paper this morning. Didn't you see it?
I didn't get the time to read it. Who are you?
My name is Melody Mercy.
And you're his cousin?
Oh yes, we were quite close. Please, I'm begging you, please solve Louis Mullaney's death.
You know what they say, a friend in need is a pest, but I thought, what the hell, I owed the guy. Louis Mullaney taught me everything I know about being a sleuth, and besides, the sound of greenback slapping across my palms is music to my ears any day.
I'll take the case.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
If Louis was dead, that means something big was going down. I figured I'd get help from an old friend in the cop business. We used to drink out of the same bottle, so he may be willing to give me some helpful pointers as to what I'm looking for.
Frank Moore.
Roger Corin. It's been a long time.
I'm here about Louis.
Oh, yeah. Heard about that. Practically raised you.
How much do we know?
Well, before his murder, he was trying to solve that detective case. You know, the one that every time a private eye tries to solve, he gets bumped off.
How did he die?
Gunshot to the back of the head. My guess is whoever killed him stood by the doorway.
Okay. Well, I want you to send me those case files he was working on. Any people who are left alive, I want you to send me their names.
Oh, and by the way, there was this girl named Melody Mercy. She came into my office claiming to be Louis's cousin, but I don't think she's legit. Can you look her up for me?
You suspect her?
I don't know what to suspect. All I know is something felt off. Would you look her up for me?
Yeah, I got it.
Thank you.
And Raj, be safe out there.
You too.
I spent
the next 2 days up to my ankles in case files trying to figure out what Louis was working on. It was a series of cases starting with the murder of Detective Vincent Goodwill and his missing fiancée Helen McBride. Several people who were close to Goodwill shortly got cut down after his death. Then anyone who tried to solve those cases after that got visit from the Reaper, make the case remain unsolved. I knew it would be dangerous for me to take the case, but Louis was my friend. If anyone was gonna avenge him, it'd be me. When Frank finally called saying he had a few folks for questioning, I was more than ready to get away from the case files for a bit.
Hey Frank, who'd you get?
Let's see, I got his maid, his landlady, his secretary, his neighbor, oh, and his cousin you told me about, Melody.
Oh yes, what do you know about Melody?
Well, I don't know what to tell you, but he did actually have a cousin named Melody Mercy. Honestly, I'm not surprised if she hired you to solve his murder. I heard from his mother that they were very close when they were younger.
Well, let's go see what these people know about his death.
So, how'd you know Detective Louis Mullaney?
I was his maid. I worked for him for 3 years. He paid very good. I was so sorry to hear about his death.
Where were you at the night of the murder?
I was at my house, having dinner with my mother.
Miss, did Mr. Mullaney have any enemies?
Oh, there was always those he managed to lock up, but...
Yes?
There was the secretary, Dorothy Gray. Mr. Mullaney always seemed suspicious of her. Is that all?
Yes, miss, that's all.
Thank you.
The secretary, huh?
Yeah.
I was his landlady. The secretary always seemed a little shady, but...
He wrote about the case, but he always seemed stressed. Something about his secretary.
Your name? How did you know Mr. Mullaney?
I'm Dorothy Gray. I was his secretary.
Oh, so you're his secretary. Tell me, where were you on the night of the murder?
I was at home.
Can anyone have testified to this?
No.
Dorothy, did Mr. Mullaney have any enemies?
Well, there was always those who he had put in jail, but this last case really did seem to take a toll on him. I believe he suspected someone was going to murder him.
Found the murder weapon.
Really? Where?
In the trash bin outside Miss Gray's house.
Miss Gray, will you come with us?
But why?
Dorothy, the murder weapon was found in your trash cans. And every other person we talked to seems to think you had something to do with the murder.
But I haven't done anything!
Come on.
Please, you've got to believe me! I haven't done anything!
Frank, do you really think it was her? I'll ask her a few more questions, but the odds are against her. You all right?
This doesn't feel right to me. I'm gonna go take a walk.
Detective Corn, sir.
Yes?
I have something to confess. I wasn't entirely truthful back there.
What do you mean?
Well, you see, that Miss Mercy, she paid me to imply that it was the secretary that had committed the murder. I took the money only because I'm out of a job, you see. But then I realized it was wrong. Miss Gray never did anything but treat me kindly, and I wouldn't want anything bad to happen to her.
Miss Mercy told you to lie?
Yes, but I don't know why. I'm sorry I couldn't be any more help.
Melody Mercy found dead X Street, X Street!
Hey, Paperboy, let me see that.
Miss Melody Mercy from a local nearby town has been found dead, presumably from a gunshot wound. It is assumed that she was mugged, as her dead body was found in an alleyway, and any money or identification had been taken. Strangely, her cousin, Detective Louis Mullaney, was found dead just 2 days earlier, despite Melody's body looking like it had been dead longer.
What?
Hey, Frank! Frank!
Don't condemn the girl just yet! Some new information has just come up.
What'd you find out?
You see, I don't think Melody Mercy is who she says she is.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna go review my case files. Meet me in my office in about 1 hour.
I went over the case files like there was a Chicago overcoat waiting for me. There had to be a connection among those clean sneaks. I just had to find the right link. Then there she was.
Helen McBride. My God, it was the dame all along. I gotta tell Frank he's got the wrong girl.
Melody Mercy, or should I say Helen McBride?
You've been gone for quite a while. I see you dressed for the occasion.
And you figured it out. Good for you. I suppose this is where I kill you.
Why? The five detectives, you killed them. They did nothing to you. Oh, come on. You're going to kill me anyways. It's not like I'm going to be around to tell the story.
Well, look at you all cocky. You know you're the one who's going to get clipped, like all the others before you. So then someone else will come along, trying to solve your death. Only to get knocked off as well.
So I'm a dead man walking. But please, as a last request, tell your story, doll.
You're funny. Well, there's not much to it. One of your very own private eyes screwed me over, and well, let's just say he screwed over the wrong girl.
The Vincent Goodwill case, your first.
We were getting married in 2 weeks, and then I found him with some skank from the slums. Who does that to a girl? Who builds her up that high just to break her heart?
I read read the police reports. You found a way to hang the chick, then you disappeared off the map.
That slut deserved what she got. Oh, you should have seen it. It was worth the world to watch her dance. Oh, trust me, honey. I'm gonna drag as many of you damn detectives down to hell with me, and we will burn.
The only one greeting the fire and brimstone will be you, sister.
Well then, say hi to God for me.
Looks like your aim was off. Now you're aiming for the slammers. You all right?
Yeah.
Thank you, Frank. Let's go get that bullet wound healed. Thank you.
Damn, think of how many good men had to die just because some bim got trigger happy with a bean shooter over some jerkwad's infidelity.
You said it. She could have just been a normal chick and moved on. It stinks that some people get so bad over just one little mishap.
And it's always the ones you least expect. Pour another slug of that confidence, will ya?
Frank?
Yeah?
Promise me we will never get mixed up in the little plights of the world.
I'll drink to that.
With a hooch in my hand, a friend at my side, and stories to talk about, I close the case.
Action.
Mr. Corrin, sir.
Yes. It's Detective Corrin. I can't remember your name.
Action.
Roger Moore?
There's a heckin' truck in the middle of our set! I'm so mad!
Frank Moore.
Roger Cornyn, my god, it's been a long time.
How much do we know?
Well, he, got murdered. He was on that case.
We did it.
We did it. Good job, man.
Good job, Frank.
Oh,
that's terrible.
Yeah, I should have gotten the other stuff.
Yeah.
We need more after this, huh? Mm-hmm. We need more of that after this.
Garner,
case.
Give us an A+, will ya?